Dear children, in the previous class, we have studied about the different states of the matter, the types of the solids, that is crystalline and amorphous solid, and then the further classification of the crystalline solids depending upon the intermolecular forces. Today we will study about the crystal lattice and the types of the unit cells. Crystal lattice, when we allow the liquid to cool down slowly, the constituent particles of the liquid, they arrange themselves in a very ordered fashion and a crystalline solid is generated. For example, when we cool water, we get ice, and ice is a crystalline solid. A crystalline solid is made up of small crystals, and the constituent pattern is known as the crystal lattice. Let's see what is a crystal lattice. The arrangement of the particles in a crystalline solid is called the crystalline lattice. A regular three-dimensional arrangement of the points in the space is called a crystal lattice. This is a crystal lattice. Here you can see that the constituent particles are regularly arranged. It is a sodium chloride crystal. Now you can very well see that this is the repeating unit. This unit is repeating itself in the three dimensions and we get this crystal lattice. So we can say that this is a unit cell, the basic constituent of a crystal lattice. Let's define unit cell. The smallest unit that shows the pattern of arrangement for all the particles is called the unit cell. That is, it is the smallest portion of the crystal lattice which, when repeated in different directions, generates the entire lattice. Here in the picture also you can see with the blue shaded portion is a unit cell. It is repeated in three dimensions, we are getting the entire crystal lattice. It resembles this. Now let us study about the unit cells in detail, that is the basic unit of the crystal lattice. This is a unit cell. When it will repeat itself in the three dimensions, we get the entire crystal lattice. These are the corners, and this is the edge, and these are the faces. Let's count the corners of a unit cell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. There are 8 corners in a unit cell. Let's count the edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. There are 12 edge lengths. Now see how many faces are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There are 6 faces in a unit cell. We must know all this to know the variety of the unit cells, that how many unit cells are there. And before discussing that also, let me discuss the parameters of a unit cell. This is a unit cell. It has 3 dimensions, that is length, breadth, and height. And there are 3 angles between these edges. And these angles are known as alpha, beta, and gamma. To define any unit cell, we have to know the length of these 3 edges and the angle between these 3 edges. Let's see the 3 dimensions. The length, breadth, and height. We must know this length, breadth, and height to define a unit cell. And other than this, we must know the 3 angles, that is alpha, beta, and gamma. The angle between this edge and this, the angle between this height and this length, and the angle between these 2 edges. These 3 angles must also be defined to define a unit cell. There are 3 types of the unit cells. the simple or the primitive unit cell, the body-centered unit cell, and the face-centered unit cell. All these three types depend upon that where the constituent particles are situated. Let's discuss each one by one. In the simple unit cell, the constituent particles are situated only at the corners. There are 8 corners, we know that. And the constituent particles will be only at these corners. In the BCC type unit cell, that is body-centered unit cell, the constituent particles are present at the corners, that is 8 corners will be occupied, and there will be one atom inside this unit cell. Let's suppose one particle is present inside it. This is BCC type. The third one is FCC type, that is face-centered unit cell. In the face-centered unit cell, the constituent particles are present at the corners, that is the 8 corners will be occupied, and the atoms or the constituent particles will be present at the center of each face. One here, here, again on these faces and these faces. We know that there are 6 faces and the constituent particle will be present in the center of the each face. So, such type of unit cell is known as FCC or face-centered unit cell. There is also another type of unit cell that is known as end-centered unit cell. This is a special case of FCC, you can say that. In end-centered unit cell, the constituent particles are present at the corners and at the center of only one set of phase. One set of phase means if the constituent particle is present here, then the other will present at the just opposite phase, that means here. Let's see the pictures. Here you can see that in the simple cubic unit cell, the atoms or the constituent particles are present at the corners only. In the body-centered unit cell, you can see the constituent particles at the corners, and in addition, there is one particle at the center of the body of the unit cell. You can see a red ball in between the white balls. Then in the third, that is face-centered unit cell, the constituent particles are present at the corners, and in addition, the constituent particles are present at the center of the each face, that is FCC unit cell. 7 unit cells. There are 7 types of unit cells depending upon the dimensions of the edge lengths and the angles between these edges. Dear children, when a unit cell is repeated in the 3 dimensions, we know that we get the entire crystal lattice. Now here you can see that this is the 3-dimensional crystal lattice, and you see this atom, I'm just pointing it out, this atom is shared by 8 unit cells. So this atom, when shared by 8 unit cell, so this corner, that is the contribution of the corner is 1/8. We must know all these things to calculate the number of the atoms per unit cell. Now, as I have explained you that in a simple unit cell, there are atoms only at the corners, and each corner is contributing only 1/8, and there are 8 corners. So, in the simple unit cell, the total number of atoms will be 1. In case of the body-centered unit cell, the atoms are present at the corners, and there is atom which is present inside the body. The atoms at the corners will contribute only 1/8, but the atom which was present inside this unit cell will contribute wholly to this unit cell. It will not be shared. So, the total number of atoms in the body-centered unit cell will be 2. Let me tell you once again how. This one which is inside this body is not shared by anyone is only of this unit cell, that one atom, plus the atoms which are present at the corners will contribute only 1/8. So 8 corners into 1 by 8 is equals to 1 plus this one. So 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So the total number of atoms in a BCC type unit cell is 2. Now FCC unit cell. In FCC unit cell, the atoms are present at the corners. 8 corners, 1/8 contribution, so 1 atom. Plus in FCC, the atoms are present at the center of the each phase. When we generate the crystal lattice like this, the atom at the center of the phase will be shared by 2 unit cells. So 6 phases, half contribution, 6 into 1 by 2 is equals to 3. So 3 contribution by the atoms at the faces and 1 contribution by the atoms at the corners. 3 plus 1 is equals to 4. So in the FCC type of the unit cell, there are 4 atoms per unit cell. So dear children, I have explained you the crystal lattice, the lattice points, the unit cells, the parameters of the unit cells and different types of unit cells depending upon the situation of the constituent particles. I'm sure everything is clear to you.